write the equation of the hyperbola in standard form. On the right, we have the standard form for the equation of a parabola. Analyzing the given equation, notice the x squared term is positive and the y squared term is negative, which indicates in standard form, we'll be using the first form of the equation where we have the x part minus the y part equals 1. This indicates if we were to graph the hyperbola, we would have a horizontal transverse axis and the hyperbola would open to the left and the right. To begin, let's gather the x squared and x terms together, as well as the y squared and y terms together, and move the constant to the right side of the equation. The given equation is equivalent to 36x squared minus 360x minus 25y squared minus 200y, and then adding 400 to both sides, we have equals 400. For the next step, we'll factor out the greatest common factor of 36 from 36x squared minus 360x, and we'll factor negative 25 from negative 25y squared minus 200y. Factoring 36 from the first two terms, we have 36 times the quantity x squared minus 10x. We will complete the square on x squared minus 10x in the next step, which means we'll have to add a constant inside the parentheses. Let's leave room for the constant. And now we'll factor negative 25 from negative 25y squared minus 200y, which gives us minus 25 times the quantity y squared, and then factor negative 25 from negative 200y leaves us with positive 8y or plus 8y. And again, we're going to complete this square on y squared plus 8y in the next step, so we'll have to add a constant in the next step. On the right, we still have 400. And now let's complete this square on x squared minus 10x. Recall, to do this, we need to add the square of half of the coefficient of x, or the square of negative 10 divided by 2, which is the square of negative 5, which is equal to 25. We need to be careful, though. When we add 25 here, we're not just adding 25 to the left side of the equation, because notice if we distribute, we have 36 times 25, which is actually 900. And therefore, to have an equivalent equation, we now need to add 900 to the right side. Again, by adding 25 inside the parentheses, we're really adding 36 times 25, which is 900, and therefore we also have to add 900 to the right side. And now we complete the square on y squared plus 8y by adding the square of half of 8 inside the parentheses. Well, the square of 8 divided by 2 is 4 squared, which is equal to 16. We add 16 inside the parentheses. But notice when distributing, we really subtracted 25 times 16. And since 25 times 16 is 400, by adding the 16 inside the parentheses, we really subtracted 400 from the left side. So now we need to subtract 400 from the right side. And now let's factor the trinomials inside the parentheses. I'll go ahead and show some extra work here. Both of them are perfect squares. But factoring like we normally do, we would have two binomial factors, the factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of 25 that add to negative 10 are negative 5 and negative 5. We have two factors of x minus 5. And now factoring y squared plus ay plus 16, we have y and y. The factors of 16 that add to 8 are 4 and 4, giving us two factors of y plus 4. So now let's write the equation as 36 times the square of x minus 5 minus 25 times the square of y plus 4 equals, on the right, 400 plus 900 minus 400 is 900. We know we need the right side to be equal to 1, so now we divide both sides by 900. On the left, we'll divide each product by 900. And now we simplify. 36 and 900 share a common factor of 36. 900 is equal to 36 times 25, and 36 divided by 36 simplifies to 1. 25 and 900 share a common factor of 25. Again, 900 is equal to 36 times 25, and 25 divided by 25 simplifies to 1. Which means in standard form, the equation of the hyperbola is the square of x minus 5 divided by 25 minus the square of y plus 4 divided by 36 equals 900 divided by 900 is equal to 1. So this is the equation of the hyperbola in standard form. And now let's determine h, k, a, and b. Notice h is with the x part and k is with the y part. Because we have x minus 5, h is positive 5. Because we have y plus 4, k is negative 4. Let's make sure we understand why this is negative 4. Notice to identify k, we need to have the form y minus k, and we have y plus 4. And y plus 4 is equivalent to y minus negative 4, which is why k is negative 4. The denominator of the x part is a squared, which indicates a squared equals 25, and therefore a equals 5. B squared is the denominator of the y part, and therefore b squared equals 36, which indicates b equals 6. Notice a equals 5 because 5 squared equals 25, and b equals 6 because 6 squared equals 36. So again, we know a equals 5 and b equals 6. I hope you found this helpful.